Can I get your attention, please? Woo! Yo, yo. You ready for this? Coming at you from Wicked Big Studios in Peabody, Massachusetts.
Ladies and gentlemen,
sit back, buckle up, because you're in the happy hour with your boy.
What's up, everybody, and welcome back to the happy hour, guys. Good to have you here on a Tuesday night. It's the special, and I'll tell you what, this is one of my favorite times of the year. As you see there, we're in the boardroom here. We're plotting and planning. I got all the paperwork here, guys, and we're here in the happy hour boardroom. One of the things I wanted to let you guys know is, as always, we're being brought to you by our friends at Boom, Old School Labs. Old School Labs is the sponsor of this year's preview show, and I'll tell you, I couldn't be more happy about it. Promo code King Hap will save you 15% site-wide. This week, they just launched pumpkin spice protein. I'll tell you what, I got it here at the Wicked Big Studios and Lodge, and I love it. Nothing beats my favorite, the tiramisu. I'll tell you guys, when you got the low sugar and you got high protein like that, tasting delicious, you gotta love it. Get over to oldschoollabs.com. Promo code King Hap, save yourself 15% site-wide. Boom. Also, guys, being brought to you by our friends at Recess. Guys, Recess is absolutely the best focus drink. Change your mood, a euphoria without any alcohol. Promo code KingHap saves you 15% over at takearecess.com, the most delicious mood-altering drink on planet Earth, guys. Make sure you get over there. Give it a whirl. Let them know you're with the Happy Hour Social Club. Promo code KingHap saves 15%. Guys, one of my very favorite times of the year. And, you know, you need to have a special taste, kind of like when you get pumpkin spice from Old School Labs. You got to have a special taste in your mouth when you get excited for Mr. Olympia like myself. I get really amped up, and I'll tell you, everybody knows I'm usually out in Las Vegas, Nevada, live out there, and I am enjoying it every second. This year, unfortunately, I won't be, but I'll tell you what I did do is I called in one of my very, very good friends and my very, very good, I'll tell you, specialist on this, I mean, subject matter expert who'll be going to Las Vegas in my stead. I'll tell you what, he's going to be there enjoying it, and everybody's going to have a good time. I'm real sorry I won't be there, but this man will be, the one and only Soog. What's up, Soog? Good to have you, brother.
What's going on, Happy? How you doing?
Living. You know how it is, my man. It's good to have you. You're looking great as always, and I'll tell you, one of the things that's funny is people don't know is, you know, you and I, you know, had some good times playing fantasy sports, etc., but we go back and forth on this bodybuilding thing. We see, you know, we watch it live at home when we're not there, or I'm there sending pictures, we're talking, holy shit, you see that? It's just a great time of the year, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is. I'm loving it. I'm heading out to Vegas next week. Gonna see, and you know what got lucky this year though, Happy? You know this. So I make all my reservations and everything for the O, and then the football schedule comes out. Boom, Patriots play in the Raiders.
That is awesome.
So we get that as well.
That is, and you know what's good about it? I called it at the beginning of the year, and I'll tell you, if to all the Raiders, you know, the Raiders employees, guys, what are you guys on? I mean, you guys must be drinking unlimited amounts of Lorenz from Clearwater Distillery, because I'll tell you what, I gave him a call, and I said, hey, if I want to get us a little bit of a luxury box, you know, maybe get the Happy Hour Social Club luxury box going, what are you guys charging to get it for one day? I could not believe when they told me that it is $65,000 to get a luxury box for the Patriots versus the Raiders. Two friggin' last place teams, so you gotta be crazy, you know?
Yeah, you know, for a regular season game, my friends are in the thing, they call it the club, and yeah, it's in the end zone, and it's like a club, and it's $500 a ticket. Standard and I program. Said, I said, I just, you know, I'm not paying $500. After paying for the O and all that, I'm not paying $500 for a regular season game, especially between these two teams.
And, you know, the thing that I don't like about it, and it's not that I'm being a hater, but I love me the New England Patriots. And I'm a big Raiders fan this year. I thought they were going to – I mean, everybody knows that listens to the Happy Hour on Wednesday nights or Thursday night sports spin. I was calling them, you know, being quite the competitor this year, maybe even a Super Bowl contender. Devontae Adams hasn't disappointed, but I'll tell you, the rest of that team hasn't, besides Jacobs, obviously. But, wow, what a disappointment that Raiders team's been. And for this to be that weekend out there, just – it was almost too good to be true. And, of course, the old body breakdown on King Hap, ankle gate rearing its ugly head, ladies and gentlemen. But I won't be making the trip, unfortunately, and I'll miss you badly out there, my man. But I'll tell you what, this is to be continued, correct?
Absolutely.
Let me ask you this now. This is what we got to start on. A lot of craziness going on with Mr. Olympia this year. It is, you know, it's going to be a week from this Saturday coming up. So I'm glad we got the Mr. O preview show out early. I mean, Phil Heath, who's, you know, I've had the pleasure of having a, you know, Zoom call with and having some good times, as everybody here knows. But he says he agrees with me. This is the deepest, most exciting lineup maybe ever. And anything can happen. I mean, people can be jumping those lineups in anywhere in the standings this year. You got to agree, correct?
I absolutely agree. And I think that what we're going to see is we're finally going to see a shakeup of the top five, you know, and I know that we're going to talk about our predictions and things like that, but I bet between you and me, there's going to be a few shakeups in there. And I mean, what would be better than a shakeup at the top?
I'm not 100% sure if it will be at the top. You guys are going to have to stick around to hear who I got at number one. But Soog, I'm going to give you a quick rundown here because, guys, this is basically what it is. 36 people qualified for this event. Four people are going to be out, which, I mean, some are understood. I know that Nathan Diaz are being out. Safe to say he won't be there. Also, Sean Clarita, he did qualify. However, he's going to be moving down to the 212. Good move by him. I couldn't see him even coming anywhere near the top 10 in this lineup. Reagan Grimes is out. Steve Cucullo, who, you know what's funny? Steve Cucullo, you know, he's qualified but won't be competing. Yeah. But this used to be one of my favorite bodybuilders. And I'll tell you, this put a bad taste in my mouth when I went ahead and looked and seen that he had a fan club. And I think I told you this already. His fan club to get a picture, follow him on his special social media, whatever, get, you know, videos, etc. $100 a month from his fans. Guys, that is just awful.
That's gouging. First of all, you're not that good. Much respect for what you do. You're not that good, and that's not good for the sport.
Nope. $100 a month is something that's absolutely ridiculous. I mean, Jay Cutler has a Cutler Club for free. And if you pay a little bit extra a month, you can get, you know, live Zoom calls with them, things like that. And Jay Cutler is the most wealthy bodybuilder from bodybuilding only ever. I mean, obviously, Arnold Schwarzenegger being the obviously the wealthiest, you know, but all from movies, etc. And being
that's a fact, huh, Cutler?
Cutler, yeah, made more money in bodybuilding than anyone else ever as a bodybuilder.
Right.
Arnold Schwarzenegger, the most money by far when you come down to, you know, dollars and cents. I made sure I did my research on
I'm sure you did. And you know what? To me, he earned it with that 2009. You know, to me, my favorite, that was my favorite physique ever. My favorite physique, Olympia physique ever on any stage. I thought it was unbelievable.
I think, honestly, the funny thing is, I think that the best physique I ever seen, 2003, Ronnie Coleman, maybe the greatest conditioning ever on stage. And I'm going to talk about that a little later on.
All right.
But I just a quick one now, guys. I'm going to give you this rundown. This was last year's top 10. I'm going to give you 11 because one of my very favorite bodybuilders finished number 11 last year. Number 11, the beast, Raleigh Winkler. You know I love Raleigh. Raleigh's a fan favorite, and I'll tell you what, he's a former fan-only vote where he got the belt for having the most fan votes ever. Hadi Chopin got it last year, who's a favorite Suggs. I know that going in, and we'll have to see exactly where that, you know, your prediction on him comes out. But I mean, Raleigh Winkler not in it this year after an injury. That's sad news.
Very painful. The best poser on the planet, as far as I'm concerned. Nobody does those first and secondary flexes just the way that he does. I just think he's the best, the true showman as well.
And Beantown Bad Boy, I know he's a favorite of his as well. I see you over there in the VIP chat, guys. All you guys in the VIP chat, feel free, if you guys have a top five, whatever, go ahead and throw it out there. If not, this will be posted, the picture along with this will be posted tomorrow on all podcast sites and on my Instagram, guys. Feel free to throw your top five in the chat. That'll be actually good to look and see. And maybe if someone hits it right, we'll send you out a VIP prize pack from maybe Old School Labs or Liquid IV, etc. Guys, make sure you guys get on over there and show some love. Now, Soog, number 11, Muhammad Saban was number 10, Aiken Williams, 9, Justin Rodriguez, 8. Ann Valari was 7. William Bonick, 6. You know I love me some William Bonick.
I know you love him.
Nick Walker, 5. Hunter Labrada, 4. Heidi Chopin was 3, Brandon Curry 2, and Rami, Big Rami, was 1. Now, here's my question. In that lineup, me and you spoke offline, and there are some people in there that I don't think belonged in these locations in the top 10, well, 11. But one thing I did, you know, I'll address them all as we go, but, I mean, you see some glaring, did you see any glaring errors on that top 10 from last year?
I didn't think that I Hunter Labrada and Nick Walker were coming in. They're newcomers. They both cracked the top 5. I think that they're flip-flopped. I just think that I like Walker's package better. I like Walker's package better. Anyway, but I think
you can use it.
Hunter Labrada, and I'm sure that he's going to place high again this year. But I just feel like I don't know if it's a familial thing that they like the Labrada name or what it is. But I just didn't see him being that high. Other than that.
I thought here? I got a quick question from the VIP chat wants to know. Hey, Sug, what are your thoughts on Big Nick Walker with his age as the next one to take over the Mr. O? I mean, I'd have to say Nick Walker is a beast. And, you know, one of the things I like about him is he is improving daily, I feel like. I mean, what are your thoughts here? The VIP chat wants to know, Sug.
The best follow all year on Instagram was Nick Walker. He was the best to come in, and he showed his 10 days out today. He looks dry. He looks good. He worked on his mask, and I think he's tightening it right up. He's taking a big Rami approach to this. I think that he could be the giant slayer.
Ooh, we'll see. You know what? I'll tell you, I'm a big fan too. My guys, and I'll tell you what, if you guys are looking to follow some of these guys, you know, a little workout motivation. I also told Sook, Derek Lungsford, one of my very favorite falls on social media. This guy is incredible. I mean, his smoking hot wife and they make some goofy videos as well. And, you know, she does it for the women as he does the bodybuilding and the motivation for the men. You said Hunter Labrada. I thought that was kind of it was controversial placing because he was at 4. I thought he was down. He should have been down around the 6-7.
That's where I had him.
You know, I had him down there. I had Bonick ahead of him. Maybe I'm biased, but I'll tell you what, I thought the total, you know, head to toe, you know, because here's the thing. When you look at these things, they're not just one from the front. It's not always just the most muscular. If that was the case, you know that Raleigh Wiggler would win it every year. Derek Lungsford. Yes, that's one of my favorite falls on social media. Guy is maybe my new favorite bodybuilder. But Heidi Chopin, I know he got the fan vote last year. I know he's a favorite of yours. Were you surprised he was down at 3?
Here's the deal. I mean, it's so much of it. It's like Franco and Arnold, where you have the just two completely. Can you even compare them? And I think that what I love about Howdy is for a small guy, he does what Franco did back then, and he brings bulk. Since his first appearance in the Olympia, he's really thickened up the back. He used to disappear every time he turned around. He doesn't do that anymore. But I think that it would have been interesting for me to see that kid, Sean Clarida, who was going to come in around 2'11 or so. I'm not sure. I think he's a similar height to Howdy. But that would have been interesting. I think that Sean Clarida could come in too heavy for the 212, believe it or not, for his weight. But I thought that would have been interesting if he made the jump up. But yes, I am a big fan of Howdy. And I do, he can challenge. I mean, if the judges are being honest, and I think that judging in bodybuilding has been horrendous in the past, even though I don't really have much issue with last year's. I guess I do though with Hunter, Howdy. Excellent. He'll be in there in the top 10 this year. But like I say, we're going to see some shuffle.
Yeah, and one of the things I was going to say is some of these people you're going to see when I give my top 10, I'm going to give. Soog's going to, you know, he'll be rebuttaling and agreeing or disagreeing. But here's the thing with this. When you see some people move down a couple lineup in the lineup, it says less about the competitor and more about the lineup, because this lineup is super stacked. And it's like, if you were number 5 last year, being 6 or 7 this year doesn't necessarily mean. I mean, you got to remember this. Lungsvid last year was Mr. Olympia 212. Now, he's moved up here. He's working with Hani Rambod, and I'll tell you what, Hani Rambod is the number one coach in all of bodybuilding, because I'll tell you, man, this man going from Phil Heath, etc., down the line. He's working with Hardy this year. He's working with, Derek Lunsford as well. He looks like I don't know what the hell they're paying this guy. This guy must be making money hand over fist, though, right?
I think it's interesting when you look at the social media, Derek, and you look at the social media, Hardy. Hardy was heavy out of the Olympia, out of the gate last year through his guest posings and things like that. And he was doing a lot of training videos. And then he's just kind of shut it down. It's funny. What do these guys hide? Like, we're going to see what we see on stage. It doesn't matter what you look like 10 days out. Like, just show us. Just show us. We want to see it.
And, you know, I seen a video 2 weeks out of Big Rami. Rami, 2 weeks out of the Olympia, guys, 315 pounds. Holy jeez. He was 280. He was like 283 last year at the Olympia. 315, 2 weeks out. That's unbelievable.
So through the grapevine, it's been leaked that he plans on coming in at 295, which is lighter than he's ever come in on. That's how much the conditioning is going to be everything. You know, you got some people like Walker and Hunter Labrada who put on some extra clay and everything, but they're going to have to tighten that shit up because I'm telling you, if Rami comes in at 295, forget about it. Just the contest is over.
Yes, it's going to be scary. And I'm going to tell you what, guys, I'm going to start off down at number 10. So again, I'm going to ask you what you think. And I can promise you, you won't hear Big Rami's name right away. He's going to be a little higher up than this, but number 10. And I got Ann Valari at number 10. He finished last year at number 7. Again, I mean, the first thing I wrote right next to him, I wrote, says less about him, more about the lineup. I know I'd already said that, but Span's a great all-around bodybuilder. He's just not he's going to crack the top 10 because he's a top 10 bodybuilder. I think nothing more, nothing less. He has good conditioning, good. I mean, he looks good, good from the front, good from the back. But, I mean, he doesn't steal the show in any one pose and in any one body part. I think that's pretty safe to say, right?
I'm with you. And, you know, so he was just number 7. I mean, I think he was 7 2 years in a row. But I've got a couple other people that I've put into the top 10, some newcomers, some guys who weren't there before. So I love your call with Ian at number 10.
Yeah, one of the guys that I'm gonna leave out of the top 10 that I had in the top 10 till last week. I seen a video of Blessing, and for me to even try to say his full name, Blessing out of Bayou, I'll say. But Blessing looked fantastic in some of the other smaller competitions. He was very, very bloated in the video I seen, and I'm starting to think that maybe number 1 he peaked and then came down and he doesn't have enough time to peak again, or maybe it was just a flight retaining a little bit of water. Maybe they get him back on point. He didn't look good. He just misses the top 10 of my after seeing that video. I had him at number 10. He gets bumped out. Blessing, I mean, he has a future, but right now I think he stays out of the top 10. You agree?
Not in my top 10 either. And what the thing is, that also, I think that he's got to get his wheels in proportion with his upper body. He's got a good upper body. He's got good round muscle bellies. I think that he's just someone for the future. And again, like you said, peaking twice a year, that's hard, man. And to come in, I mean, Walker did it. You saw he looked a little bit more slight in the Olympia than he did in the Arnold. And so it's just hard. You have to carry a lot of mass to be able to do that. So I agree with you.
Yep. One number 9, Soog. Now this might be a surprise to some people, but I'm gonna say Michael Krizo Krizak. I mean Krizak, I don't even know how to say his last name, but they call him Michael Krizo from
Slovakia. Krizanak.
Yeah, he's a former mass monster. This guy was just enormous. I mean, yeah, basically just huge, guys. He's looking super dry right now, grainy for days. His muscles are ripped right now. This is the best he's ever looked, absolutely striated. I'll tell you what, the one thing I will tell you from looking at him in videos is that this man needs protein. He looks almost albino to me until he gets that protein on. But
what that reminds me of? Shows back in the day, Happy. Do you know? So I moved out to California, and then it wasn't like this thing where you bring the whole happy hour with you and you got your whole crew with you. You go alone and you're backstage and you need to get painted or need to get oil on your back. And you're asking complete strangers, other guys, and you're just like, hey, you might put a little oil on my back. That's the way it was back in the olden times. I actually have Crizzo higher.
Really?
That's awesome. I do. I have him higher, and there's a couple reasons. And I don't know if you want me to bring it up now or later.
Yeah, I'd like you to bring it up now, but let me just ask you this, because one of the things I want you to comment on is he's never competed in a Mr. Olympia yet, which is, right. I mean, understandable. But here's the one thing I'm going to ask you, because I want to hear exactly what you think. But do you think that him, and for everybody in the chat, bigger is better? Yes, I agree. But here's the thing with Chris, he goes out there and he rattles when he poses. A lot of shaking going on. And I'm wondering if the Olympia judges may go ahead and shy a little bit away from him due to that. I'm actually docking him a little bit here, not because I think that's a reason, but because I think the Olympia judges might. Yo, what do you think?
It looks weak. You look weak when you shake on stage. I mean, that's part of it. The whole thing is you're flexed the whole time. You know, the shaking thing is very strange. The reason why I have him so high is hopefully, and I forgot what the supplement was that helps with the shaking. I forgot what that was. I apologize. I'm old. but here's the thing with Crizzo is that he brought it on when he switched over to the IFBB Pro. And he in order to qualify, he didn't have to really peak. The competition wasn't there. Yes. He took advantage of that. So whereas, you know, you'd spike this much on a peak, he only had to go like that kind of round, and now he can go back up. He plans on coming. Well, I heard that he'll be in at around 293. So he's going to be around Big Ramy's weight. That's tremendous. And he's 10 days out, he's shredded. Yep. He's absolutely shredded. He had new pictures today. Unbelievable. And his shape is good. His proportion is there. I love it. Great newcomer. Really excited for this guy.
Yeah, me too. I'm dying to see. You know what I want to see is I want to see at the beginning when he's out there and he's next to some of these people. I'd love to see him standing next to like a Nick Walker, standing next to, you know, Brandon Curry. I want to see what he has just an amateur just last year, right? And now stepping into the biggest show of them all, let's see what he has. I don't think that even if he does finish down around 9, I don't think that that's the highest this man's ever going to get. I think.
Oh, no. Well, you know what? You know, one thing, I don't know. Do you know this? I don't know that I've ever seen him from behind.
I did see just videos that they had. I believe it was Nick Trigili with Bodybuilding and BS had a video, I'm almost sure. And I did see it. He looks friggin' huge. He's scary, period. End of conversation, in my opinion. And number 9, nothing to shake a stick at in this lineup.
Not at all.
Glad you got him higher, because I'd love to hear. I'm dying to hear where you have him pasted. Speaking of pasting, I'm ready to, you know, right here, guys. I'm putting the Dukes up. I'm ready to rock and rumble. Number 8, and this is going to sound crazy. Last year, number 4. This year, number 8. Hunter Labrada, and I'll give you the reasons why. The reason is, and this is true, he's slipping. I don't think he deserved 4th last year. I think last year he was more 6th. Maybe 7th. And I think with the lineup, he's moving to 8th, because I know that you're adding in people that weren't even in the lineup last year that I think have him beat. Now, number 4 last year, I thought was kind of a little bit, I thought it was controversy, to be honest.
I agree.
At best, he was five because Nick Walker, I know that, like I said, another favorite of the Beantown bad boy. Nick Walker had him beat last year, hands down. I thought that it come down to Hardy and Nick Walker for third. You know what I mean? I think maybe Hardy beat him out. But I thought, actually, we'll talk about another little controversial thing I had last year. But I think here we see Hunter Labrada down at eight. I'm sure that you probably think he's going to be higher. You think I'm a little crazy.
I think he's going to be higher just because I think he is so well coached. And I think that the other thing is that when it comes to – so Hunter Labrada, last year, if we can scroll back and look at our texts from last year, when Labrada placed – when they called Walker and they hadn't called Labrada, I freaked out last year. I'm like – I go – what does it look like in person? What does it look like in person? Because no fucking way was that the case. So, I like the call there. I started counting it at eight. And what I went with, because I don't know. I mean, I went with Ian at eight this year, moving from seven to eight last year. And I think what we're just going to see is we're going to see some maturity. And we're going to see him fill out that midsection just a little bit. He's got very long chest muscles. His chest bellies are long. If he can tighten those things up, get real dry, I think it'll look good on stage.
Yep. Beantown, Beantown bad boy asking here about Sean Roden actually unfortunately passed. He passed away during the that's what caused him to disappear. The sex abuse case happened, and he was making a comeback. He was in a lot of the you started to see him around bodybuilding a little bit, but unfortunately flexor on Sean Roden during the height of COVID. He was one of the bodybuilders, him, the Bull, good friend of the show, the Bull, unfortunately. And then Sean Roden, who, you know, I met in person multiple times. He was actually an excellent, excellent person to me when I met him. I'll tell you, God rest him, RIP. But Sean Roden unfortunately passed. So I know that you're, that's devastating news to any bodybuilding fan, correct?
It kills me every time it happens. You know, it happens in our sport. I suffered a little bit of a bump in the road, and, so I'm always very aware of it now. I'm even more aware of it now, but, I hate to see that stuff. And hopefully everybody stays healthy these last few days and beyond that.
Yeah, that was actually what I wrote down, is that there should be, like I said, there was 36 qualified, 32 should go ahead and, you know, compete. I wrote down because you never know, somebody could get sick, et cetera, miss the show. Number seven, now you had number eight, you had Ian, right? So number seven, I'm going to tell you who I got here. I got a newbie here as well. I got Andrew Jacked here. I mean, this man might win that. It might win the Mr. O in the next year or two, I think. He is a freak. Tiny waist, huge shoulders. The thing with this guy, when he's on stage, I can't take my eyes off this guy when he's out there. His real name is Chindu Andrew Obakina. Andrew Jacked is what they call him. But I'll tell you what, this man is one of those people that you can't take your eyes off him on stage. The sight of him is so pleasing that you kind of are drawn to his muscles, especially from the front. You know, some people are like that, but some other people, you know, you kind of look at, it doesn't look as good to you, so you kind of go to the
doesn't stand part. Out right. Doesn't stand out. I always felt that about Akeem Williams. I always felt the same way about him. I don't have Andrew Jacked in my top 10.
Yep.
I love it. He's a USA guy. There's 10 guys from the USA who qualified. Which I feel good about bodybuilding, still strong as it can be as compared to the rest of the world. But wow, you got Andrew Jacked in there. I love it.
He needs to shred down a little bit and peel his back. You don't win bodybuilding competitions just from the front. I said that a little earlier. His rare poses is where he slides. I think Andrew Jacked, especially, like I said, it's good to have a guy from the USA up there. He could be future Mr. Olympia, in my opinion. I know you have him outside the top 10, but I mean, truth is that This man is a beast, and even if he didn't make it this year, he was predicted to be number in the top five by Brandon Curry, FYI.
Well, that's so funny that you say that, because with Brandon Curry, one of the things I was going to bring up is conditioning with Andrew Jack, yep. Right? And isn't that always the situation with Brandon Curry too? Is he in condition? I think we're going to see – we are going to be so pleasantly surprised at how in shape everybody comes in, how dry they come in, because Big Ramy's setting the tone. They yep. got 10 days out. Everybody knows he's coming in that shape. And I think that that's what we're going to see. I don't know if Andrew Jack will be able to do that. So that's why I kept him out.
Yep. Jay Cutler also says that he's going to shock the world and get a great location in the top five, in the top five or so. We'll see what that is, though. I think that they actually have some business interests together, if you know what I'm saying.
Right. So was that your number seven?
That was number seven for me. Who do you got going at number seven?
I got the other watermelon. I got water balloon. I got Brandon Curry. And that's a big drop for him. And, but I think that it speaks to this year. It speaks to, the competition is going to be like in this thing.
Let me tell you this, right? So, I thought that you were going to kill me on this, because I have Brandon Curry at number six, which is funny that you have him at number seven, because that's a far cry from last year. Now, he was number two last year. I didn't think he was number two last year. That was the other controversial.
No, I don't either.
Party beat him out. I'm not a huge Party Chupin fan, but I'll tell you what. I mean, not that I'm not a fan, but he's not one of my favorites. But Brandon Curry certainly isn't. And let me tell you this. This is what really crawls up in my craw is Brandon Curry lost the Arnold this year. William Bonnick beat him this year, and William Bonnick had gyno and a leg injury at the Arnold, and I think that he beat him straight up. If you guys go on the internet and take a peek, you gotta say,
I was going back and forth with you on that one. I first of all, why is Mr. Olympia doing the Arnold?
Beats me. I mean,
I don't get it.
He looked okay at the Arnold. I'm obviously, the man looks tremendous. I mean, compared to myself or, the next guy down the hall. But, I mean, as Mr. Olympia, when you're comparing him to Big Ramy, somebody like a Bonnick or, up the line, any of these guys, I truly think Brandon Curry is slipping, and I think that he's going to come in sixth this year, and I think this is the highest you ever see Brandon Curry place again, in my opinion. Conditioning's always questioned with him, and also, the other thing is I'm questioning the fact that he's as dedicated as he once was. Do you kind of sense any of that?
100%. He's this. You know what? He's the modern day without the shape Flex Wheeler. Yes. Flex Wheeler. Everybody always questioned. Always questioned his desire, his drive, and I got to agree. I didn't know that Flex. I trained at the Mecca when Flex trained there. And it was Sean Ray and Flex and Chris Cormier and all those guys always, they always huddled. And I wish that I knew, I wish I could go back in time knowing that cut on him and see if I can see that in his training. You know what I mean?
Yes.
But yeah, I agree with you. He'll never place higher again. Great call. My number six, I got the new guy, the Nigerian Lion, Samson Dauda. 330 pounds of sex appeal.
I got him highlighted here because I wanted to bring him up. I'm glad you brought him up. This man is enormous. Am I wrong?
And he's beautiful. I mean, when you look at the shape of Crizzo and you look at the shape of Samson Dauda, they're very similar. They're bringing in a very aesthetic package that is absolutely huge. Size is back. Size is back, and I love that people now are being rewarded for their size and not penalized. They're not being penalized by the likes of, like, starting way back with Ferrigno. I look at the pictures of Ferrigno, and I think Ferrigno looks amazing next to the Austrian Oak. And then, you know, on down the line, Matarazzo, local guy. I loved his mask. Was a great guy to me, nice guy in the gym. But, you know, Paul DeLette. Well, Paul DeLette could never put a package together. He didn't know how to pose. But I love that mask. And so I love to see a guy like Samson Dauda. I'd love to see him crack the top five. But for this time, I got him coming out. And that's basically going in with just looking at some pictures that I've seen of him and not knowing much about him. You know, we don't he hasn't been around, so we don't really know that much about him. But I'm still going to put him at six.
I like that pick. And, you know, I looked at him and I'm thinking to myself, he might be too big. And he just might, truthfully, he may be too big to win Mr. Olympia. The man, right. I mean, legitimately, when you see Big Rami up there, you know that he's not necessarily, too big because his conditioning is, you know, amazing. I thought that Big Rami actually won the other Olympia. I forget what year it was. He came second. Well, I mean, it is what it is. But when he became second, I thought he'd already won another one because of his conditioning. I think that he missed. And since then, his conditioning's been pretty on point. Last year, I thought, was one of his best packages. We'll talk about him as we, you know, move forward. Great pick there. We'll see exactly what, you know, where these cookies crumble. Number five, guys, and now I may regret this pick here because I'm not 100% sure, but I'm going with William Bonick right here. Another top five. I might regret it. He beat Curry at the Arnold. I truthfully think he did. I've said this to you before. He's a perfect bodybuilder. Everything on this man is muscle bellies, conditioning, size, from the front, from the back. He's amazing. The thing is with Bonick, unfortunately, is he doesn't have that knock your socks off pose. He doesn't have that knock your socks off body part. Everything, in my opinion, he's the total package. However, he just doesn't blow your socks off. I think he's top five, but I don't think he's Mr. Olympia this year. Your thoughts?
I know that my friend Happy loves William Bonick. And you have been so right over the years when I have picked against Bonick. And I'm going to do it again. I don't have Bonick in the top five. Wow. I actually have my favorite short guy, Howdy, at five. Now, the reason why I didn't have Bonick on the radar is because he's doing too much.
Yes.
He's doing too much. You can't peek twice if you're going to win the big show. He's in the top five. Why is he messing around at the Arnold? Why? I just don't understand it. So, and I thought he was injured.
He was. He had the leg injury that's been fixed, and he also had that little bout with gynecomastia, but now that's been taken care of. And like I said, he beat, in my opinion, he beat Brandon Curry with both of those in at the Arnold. But I think we see him in the top five. I'm not sure. I know that some of the others I looked, I seen him, you know, down as low as, where was it? Bonick, eighth. I seen, I think that was Nick Power and Strength was the lowest I seen. He had him at eight. So you don't think Bonick in the top 10? You actually don't have Bonick. This means in the top eight, correct?
I don't. I think that times the clock's running out on Bonick. Okay. You know, that he's been in there for a long time. Again, my top five, with the exception of Howdy, are all monsters.
Yep.
And I think that, you know, that we've seen the Olympia voting come around to the way of Big Rami. We would have never thought that would have happened in the past. It finally did happen a couple of years ago. And I think that the trend now is going to be with these new massive guys.
Yep. Wow. I'm actually surprised. So number five for you is Hardy. Now, let me ask you this. You notice it. I mean, like I said, it does anything about him. Now, one of the things is Hardy, one of the issues that I notice is they talk about his shoulders.
Yeah.
There's some rumor that there was some oil pumped into them to make them bigger. I mean, listen, I ain't trying to say all these guys are Boy Scouts, but my only thing is I don't dig that whole thing, but I'm not exactly sure that that's even accurate. But I mean, your thoughts on the accusations that he has oil shoulder?
Well, you know what it is? That's actually, I think that has to do with it's Persians. People think that that's what Persians do because that's the only people we see really do that. When you see all the freaks on the internet who are using the synthol and doing that, it's all in Persia. But the fact of the matter is that shit doesn't show up on stage. There's no such thing as a striated, you know, look at Howdy. He's ripped.
Right.
I don't even like to pay any, give 1 minute to that argument because Howdy is for his size, he's almost perfect. He's almost a perfect bodybuilder.
Yeah. And I'll tell you, he's made a lot of improvements over the last
year. He really has.
Yep.
He really has. I mean, the fact that I have him out of the top five is, but one of the things is that I don't feel the judges do a great job. And, yes. I just think that there's going to be some guys who have always hung in there, like Bonick and like Howdy, who are going to start to fall back now, and the new guys are going to come in.
Right here, Heidi Chopin's deltoid controversy continued until 2021 Olympia weekend, possibly costing him the title. He had everyone threatened, he'd actually threatened to sue RX Muscle about their comments on his delts. Wow.
That's irresponsible, and that's not good for the sport. I don't know why people do that stuff. I can't stand that.
What we're going to do, guys, right? I'll tell you what. I mean, we got the two. There's number five. We got four coming up. 3, 2, 1, myself and Soog. What we're going to do, we're going to take a quick break, guys. When we come back, first off, we got to keep these lights on. If you look at this boardroom here, I mean, look how tremendous we look here in the boardroom, Soog. What we're going to do, we're going to take a brief break. And when we come back, we're going to hear the top four. I want to get your picks, guys. Keep them coming in the chat room. I'm loving hearing what everyone's taking. We're going to take this brief break. We're coming right back. Make sure you stick around.
It's a top my selector.
Hey guys, today's episode of the Happy Hour is brought to you by Liquid IV. Liquid IV is the world's greatest hydration drink, and the best part is it's good for you. Liquid IV is taking care of the Happy Hour Social Club members with 25% off. Guys, that is a great deal. Promo code King Hap will save you 25%. They have great all-new flavors like guava, apple pie, watermelon, pina colada, strawberry, and the new Happy Hour-inspired tangerine. All these flavors are refreshing and delicious. Promo code King Hap will save you 25%. And speaking of refreshing and delicious, back to your host of the Happy Hour, King Hap.
Oh, yeah. The lovely ladies of the Happy Hour, Mr. Olympia. Everybody at Mr. Olympia, should you want to stay hydrated, Liquid IV is the way to do it, guys. Get a little bit of sodium in there, and I'll tell you what, you can make sure you keep your muscles pumped all day. Promo code KINGHAP will save you 20% site-wide right now, guys, and I'll tell you what, it is cold and flu season here in New England. Get on over there. Happy Hour inspired tangerine, vitamin C infused. Guys, make sure you get your hands on it. We are back, and I'll tell you, man, I am amped up. I'm ready to be back here, and I'll tell you, I'm wishing that I was in Las Vegas, Nevada right now. I'd be having a good little dinner, getting ready to rock and rumble, but we are here even better. I'm here with the Happy Hour Social Club members, the lovely ladies of the Happy Hour, and my main man, Soog. Soog, I'll tell you, brother, I know that we've been, like I said, we've been itching for the, you know, see these last couple videos coming in, and I've been seeing some of them. I told you, the only one that really kind of got me, gave me a kick in the pants was Blessing. He looked really bloated, and a lot of the other ones, it's almost like, why are you posting this video? Do you think maybe that was a little bit of trick photography? You know, remember how they said out in Kuwait, they had that mirror, you know, the trick mirror in Kuwait. Do you think this is a little trick photography to make some people think that Blessing's coming in bloated, not looking so good, and maybe he actually is coming in with the total package?
These people have PR directors. You know, when you look at the pictures of, you know, the pictures of Rammy, the pictures of Hunter, They have people behind the scenes. They look almost contest shape. 2 weeks out, 10 days out, they look almost contest shape. That's, you know, a little manipulation. That's why I can't wait to see what happens under the lights in person. And me texting like crazy with my buddy Hap.
I can't wait. I'm all amped up. I'll tell you. Well, from here, we go to number four, Soog. So I'm going to go ahead, and you know what? I'm going to go ahead, and I'm going to leave the floor to you for the fourth pick first, and then I'll come in with my pick on this one, because I've been batting lead off here, and I'm dying to hear who you got leading off here at number four, the cleanup batter.
Crizzo. I have Crizzo. This year's Hunter and Nick coming in at number four. You know what? I've fallen for it. I've fallen for the hype. I'm going with Crizzo as the newcomer that is going to rock everybody's socks off. I can't wait to see this guy, like you said, with the tan. I can't wait to see what he does for conditioning. I've fallen for it.
Yep. Well, it's not necessarily falling for it, because I'll tell you, when you look at this man, I mean, he is, you know, the thing that I think is his veins have veins. So it's like, wow, when you see people that look like this, his muscles look grainy. I'm not lying. I looked at him. He looked like an extremely pale, like ribeye steak. That's how grainy this man looked. And I'll tell you, I like I said, anything can happen in this Mr. Olympia. If this man's first year, he's at number four, I would not be surprised. He is the total package, in my opinion. I mean, you can't necessarily think he's in the top four and he has much to work on, but if you had to say that, what would you think that he needs to do?
I don't know. Again, I haven't seen him from behind to the extent that you have. I didn't see that video. I've only seen him from the front hitting his most musculars. My only thought is that maybe he looks, when he turns around, he disappears. I don't know that. But if there's going to be a flaw with him, it's not in the front.
Oh.
It's not in the front.
He's a, like I said, he's a former mass monster. And once he chiseled it down, he chiseled it down the right way. The man does look like he was made with a hammer and chisel.
He really does. What do you have for four there, Hap?
Number four, guys, and I'll tell you, this is another newcomer, and I'll tell you, my favorite bodybuilder, ladies and gentlemen, the 212 Mr. Olympia last year is Derek Lunsford. I got Derek Lunsford at number four, and I'll tell you why. Wow. I'm going to go ahead and say, basically, this man has zero, when I say zero, gut. None. He has the best conditioning in the Mr. Olympia. He is absolutely ripped. He has a very, very slim waist, extremely wide shoulders. His back is on point. Heidi Rambaud has absolutely got this man, a man possessed, and I am drinking the Kool-Aid. He might not be big enough, in my opinion, to stand on the stage next to, you know, the Mutant and Big Rowdy, but I will say this, right? In Pittsburgh, not ready to pose. They went to him and said, you know, he was at a booth. And I'll tell you guys, if you guys want to see something impressive, this man was at a booth, not doing any kind of guest posing, nothing, in street clothes. Big Rami, he couldn't get out of Egypt. And they went to him and said, we promised Mr. Olympia, can you do us this favor? This man paled down, had no tan, nothing, got on the stage, and he looked better than Brandon Curry. And Brandon Curry is a former Mr. Olympia in the Open. And was absolutely blown to smithereens, bro. I was taken back, and I'll tell you what, at the Pittsburgh Pro, they always have the Mr. Olympia, and basically what happened was the president of the association went to him and said, we need a favor. He got there, and this man, he's very into God. He's very into believing that right place at the right time. To make the jump from 212 to the Open, number one is amazing. To be in the top five, even top 10, is going to be even better as the 212 champ. I think one of these days, you see him, the first man to win the 212 and the Open. And I'll tell you, the one last thing I have to say, he's added so much size since last year. He is absolutely enormous. That back is crazy. Go ahead. You can tell me I'm nuts, but I love this pick at number four.
First of all, every year you come in and you have some shock the world type of prediction. And I've seen it come true with you. And so it makes me start to doubt myself. Now that I didn't even have this guy in the top 10, it makes me start to doubt myself. I love the pick. I think it's bold. It's going to be my Crizzo versus your Derek.
Yes, and I'll tell you what, I think both of us are going to be, I put it this way, I would be blown away if both of our surprise picks aren't in the top 10. I can promise you that we're going to see them both up there, but I'll tell you, Derek Lung's been working with Hani Rambod, and the amount of mass he's put on is just insane. The way he looked at Pittsburgh, not even ready for a guest posing, and to just basically rip down, throw on a pair of trunks and go out there is impressive, to say the least, right?
It is. And word is that Remy purposely didn't go. That he's difficult. That he's difficult to deal with. Not exactly the best ambassador for the game. He's big, a great ambassador for Persian bodybuilding, but not exactly, you know, they're almost Dorian Yates-ish.
Yeah, and you know what else they say about him is that everywhere he goes, he is like a. He's like a superstar over there. And like he won the Mr. Olympia. He comes back. They have parades like he won the World Series. And he's one of the biggest superstars over there. And like you say, I've met the man. He barely spoke English when he and I spoke. What a I mean, what a nice guy. And on top of it all, he is freaking big, man. He is.
He's the best.
But I'll tell you, I'll talk about him in just a moment. But that leads me to number three. And I'll take this one first because you're going to, I know that you're going to disagree with this because at number three, I got Hadi Chopin. And you know, I know that you say he goes down. I know that they say the whole shoulder thing. And, you know, I don't necessarily believe in that. I mean, he has some of the most grainy, dense muscle in the whole Olympia.
He's beautiful.
Amazing conditioning. I mean, no one's going to ever disagree with that. He could have won last year, in my opinion. And
I agree.
Definitely is a fan favorite, as noted by the title belt he won from the fan vote. If the fans cheer and have anything to say with the judge's decision-making, you know Hardy's got a good chance of being up there at number three. But, I mean, you don't have him far behind at five, right?
Well, I don't have him far behind. And if you look at it, and if my memory serves me, I think that Howdy came in with the best conditioning of the top five in the past 2 years. He knows how to come in and be in condition, and that keeps him within that top five, even though he doesn't have the same stature that these other guys do. You can't argue the pick. You can't argue the pick, but I mean, it's a solid, it's a respectful pick, and I see what you're talking about. At three, I'm going to go with Hunter. Ooh. I'm going with Hunter there. And it's, you know why? Not so much that I believe in Hunter and I believe in his physique, but I do believe in bias. And I believe that the Olympia judges are some of the worst. And, you know, I'm not saying that I know every year, but even though I think I know every year, but it's just that I don't think that they do our sport a service. And I do think that they love Labrada. They loved LeBron. They loved his father. Yes. And now they love him, and they want him to be successful.
Yep, and you know, he probably will be, and he's going to be there. Like I said, there's no doubt he's a top 10 bodybuilder this year.
Yeah.
Like I said, when I gave the breakdown about him, I didn't think he deserved the number four last year. But I will tell you, one of the things about him is he is put together, and he does have a good all-around package. I don't think that he's going to necessarily be as high as you have him, but I do know that he is, I mean, he's elite, and he's up there with these guys. Like I said, you could, with the way this year comes, basically going from Friday night to Saturday night, you could see crazy movement.
Yeah.
Who gets the, you know, the water retention? Who has the best night's sleep? Who wakes up super shredded? I mean, you could see movement from Friday night to Saturday like none other this year, I think. I mean, you got to think that that's definitely a possibility, right?
Absolutely. And again, I think that your prediction is more where he is going to belong. I think mine is just going to be where he ends up based on judging bias.
Yeah, if you and I were there judging, he'd be closer to what I'm saying than what you're picking.
Precisely.
You're going with what the Olympia judges are going to give him.
But giving his full due, you know, he's a good follow on Instagram as well. And he worked hard this year, man. He made a lot of gains. Yep. He stacked up. He put on some muscle mass, man. He looks good.
Yep. And you guys know there's a couple names that haven't come out yet. And we're going to talk about those names as we got the top two coming. We got last call coming with Soog. What we're going to do, we're going to take one more last commercial, guys. And when we come back, we're going to tell you who wins it all. Beantown, I see you out there. Batista, a lot of your people are, you know, itching to hear who's going to be number one. I know there's a couple names that people are dying to hear. So what we're going to do right after this, we're going to go ahead, round out the top 10. And then we got last call coming with Soog. We'll see how it goes. Ladies and gentlemen, stick around. We'll be right back after this brief message. Boom.
Hey guys, tonight's episode of the Happy Hour is brought to you by Chili Sleep Technology. Chili Sleep Systems is a game changer. Chili's Cool Mesh Pad is the most luxurious sleep system in the industry and is also hydro-powered. This can warm you up on those cold winter evenings or cool you off during a steamy summer night. Promo code King Hap will save you 22% off an entire sleep system. This is certainly a purchase that you will not regret. Our systems can bring the temperature anywhere from 55 degrees to 115 by remote control or the Chili Sleep app. Get over to chilitechnology.com and make sure to use promo code KINGHAP to save 22%. And now, back to a man that needs absolutely no help warming it up in between the sheets, your host of the Happy Hour, King Hap.
Oh, yeah, ladies and gentlemen, Chili Sleep is now sleep.me. I'll tell you what, I use this thing every night. The only thing keeping me warm at night here in the freezing cold tundra of New England, guys, chilisleep.com. Use promo code KINGHAP now and at sleep.me. You save a whopping 30%. The funny thing is I seen people getting all pissed off out there because the Black Friday and Cyber Monday sale saved 25%, but Happy Hour Social Club members always save 30%. Wham, and there is nothing more important than a good night's sleep, right? So
that's right. You need it.
Amen. And I'll tell you, one of the things here now, I won't get a good night's sleep if I don't see these two guys up there in the top three. But I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to throw my number two out here and I'm going to let you give number one first when we get to that. But I'm going to say number two is going to be Nick Walker. I mean, I am like absolutely chomping at the bit to see Nick Walker stand next to, you know, Hardy, stand next to Lunsford, stand next to Rami, etc. But I'm going to give Nick Walker the nod here. Huge improvements this year from the offseason. I think he's gotten much bigger. He's gotten much more dense, which I didn't know if it was even possible. And this man, his conditioning has improved, which, I mean, he's got conditioning for days already, and he looks even bigger. He's freak big. And one of the last things I was going to say about him, the man's pretty much the total package. You don't get much better of a bodybuilder, in my opinion, than Nick Walker. Huge fan favorite as well. A lot of followers. A lot of people enjoy him. And you got to think, Soog, this man is going to definitely be up there in the top three, right?
I got Big Nick at two. I got Big Nick at two as well. And you know what? If Rami wakes up a little bloated on Saturday, it's going to be Nick Walker taking it over if the judges are being honest. But if Rami messes up his conditioning, Walker can take it. Have you seen this guy's biceps? You see that he is unbelievable. His training, he's psychotic. He's become a fan favorite. He's been very open. I don't know if you saw that interview where he came out and he talked about being sexually abused when he was 9 years old or so by a family friend or an uncle or something like that. And he spoke about it. He very honest about it. And this is a guy who he's a great ambassador for the sport. I'd love to see him win. I'd love to see Rami win, but I'd love to see Nick win. And I think that the mutant is apt. He's huge. He's a monster. We've got some big guys in this show. We've got Samson, Crizzo, Rami, and Nick Walker. And I'm looking forward to seeing it. I got him at number two.
Yeah, and what, like I said, I was talking about Derek Lunsford earlier, and knowing that Lunsford was the 212 winner last year, I can't wait to see him standing next to the mutant and just see the difference here. Like I said, when I was talking about Lunsford, I'm not sure he has the size to take out Nick Walker yet or that size to take out Big Ramy, but it's going to be excellent to see the diversity in these bodybuilders standing next to each other. You put Prince next to Lunsford, you know what I mean? Then you go ahead, you put Bonick in there, you know, standing next to the mutant. I mean, we're going to have guys, if you're not a bodybuilding fan, I'm sorry, and I appreciate the, we got over 100 of you sitting there listening to us live. But here's the thing. If you're a bodybuilding fan, this is the year you don't want to be home at the Wake and Bake Studios and Lounge while Suggs out in Vegas. But if you are, you're going to want to make sure you still watch this show, because I'll tell you, man, if, like you said, Rami wakes up a little bloated, you know, doesn't really nail it. You could see Nick Walker up there as the next Mr. O, correct?
Right. I think he has a Mr. O in him. Yeah. I think he has much the way that Cutler came up, and when Cutler was going up against Ronnie and took a few losses, and then Cutler broke through. That's what I see happen in Nick Walker's career. And I think, you know, it might be that I just like him. I just like the way he is. And I think he seems like a good guy. I know a lot of these guys are good guys, but Nick Walker number two, Rami messes up, Nick Walker number one.
Let me tell you this, right? You mentioned the story about the sexual abuse as a young kid. But after that, they said that his social media following grew exponentially. And one of the funny things about that is some people might, you know, go ahead and make a joke or something. No, the public really took to him. And I'll tell you what, he has not disappointed whatsoever. This man is absolutely a force to be reckoned with, has fans for days. And I mean, he is legitimately one of, if not the favorite, he's one of the favorites to win this, correct?
And yeah, a great ambassador for the sport. This is a guy who I'd love to see be Mr. Olympia. You know, an American. I just love to see it.
Yep, and it's that time, ladies and gentlemen. Soog, who do you got at number one? The motto, the man, Mr. O. That leaves one name we haven't heard yet. I got a feeling we might be in agreement on this one right now.
We've got Big Ramy at number one. Mamdua Elsbay.
Yeah, buddy. I have the same one, obviously, guys. If I had left him out of there, I'd hope you tune out of my show right now if I'd never But truth is, I mean, he looks to be in amazing shape, 315 pounds, you know, 10, it was like 10 or 11 days out. Jeez. I mean, monster. No, I mean,
if he loses 20 more pounds, I mean, it we're going to see every single striation that's on there. I mean, I can't wait to see what this freak, and I say that lovingly, this freak looks like, because, He's something special. Something special.
And you kind of knew he was coming. You know, you seen him going up as Heath was, you know, one of the top dudes. And then you seen Roden take over the title for a year. You knew the whole time Big Ramy was coming, right? I mean,
I just wondered if he was going to be just put into that category of just freakishly big guys, you know? Like, I just wondered if that was going to happen. And that he broke through is really fantastic. I love the trend in bodybuilding towards these bigger guys.
Yep. And one of the things I was going to say is Chad Nichols, who was one of Ronnie Coleman's coaches back in the day, actually says that this year, and I heard it from his mouth to my ears, he thinks that Rami will come in this year topping Ronnie Coleman's 2003 conditioning. If that happens, show's that's over, insane. Right? You got it. That would be absolutely the most insane package we ever seen, correct?
Yep. Yeah. And again, a lot comes down to the voting, but what we're talking about here is voting. And you know, they say that you have to knock the champ out. I don't agree with that. I never agreed with that. I think that if you put it down and say the mutant gets 1 point less than Big Ramy, then it's not a knockout, but he still won. You know what I mean? It's just, so I just, he can't, Ramy can't be beat if he comes in conditioning. and especially the way that Olympia judges are.
Yep, and one of the things, too, is basically, right now, the way that he looks, it looks like this is Big Rami's show to lose, but there is so much competition. And here's the other thing, Soog, we haven't seen this in years where there's this much diversity in physiques, where you got some guys that are just in the most insane shape you've ever seen. Yeah. You got waist this big with shoulder span this big. I mean, the truth is that it's going to come down to judging, and it's going to come down to who nails it Saturday and who nails it Friday. And basically, when you add it up, we're going to see who wins, and you could see a new Mr. O. But if he does come in with 2003 Ronnie Coleman conditioning, I don't think that anybody on planet Earth can beat Big Rami.
What? If I can I ask a question? Am I allowed to ask a question of you?
Of course.
All right.
Wait,
what's
baby!
The call out you want to see? What's the 5-man call out you want to see?
And this is going to sound crazy. Well, I do want to see Chris out there because I want to see him with these guys. And I want to see it now. I'm looking here. This is what I'd say. I want to see Chris. I want to say Bonick. You know me.
I love him.
Bonick. Put Bonick out there. I need Lungsford. I need Walker, and I need Rami. I got to see Walker, Rami, and Lungsford out there at the same time. It's like if I don't get that visual, and you know that they're going to do it because the 212 champ from last year, Mr. Olympia from last year, are going to be on the stage at the same time. But if I don't get to see that, like I said, you got the, you know, Chris, first year ever out there, you know, competing in a Mr. Olympia. You got Derek Lungsford making the jump up. Bonick, because it's a sentimental favorite of mine. And then I got, you know, like I said, the people I think are 1-2, Nick Walker and Big Rami. Who would you say would you be the top five you want to see out there together?
I want to see Samson Dauda out there. I want to see him standing next to Crizzo with the Mutant, Rami, and Hunter.
Oh, Hunter, yes. And you know what?
Because I want Hunter to be exposed.
If you put it this way, if you put Chris and Hunter out there at the same time, I don't think that you're ever going to see him finish above Crizzo again. The other one that I do that I need to see out there too is Ann Valari. He had a good finish last year. I'd like to see him out there and see if he's as beneath where I think. I want to see if he should comes in as low as I think he should. Like I said, I cut him down to 10. You put him up there with Big Rami, you put him up there with some of these guys and he comes out, I'd like to see exactly if I'm right or if I'm wrong. LeBron, I got to stand next to the big dogs too, because I got to see if that that number four stands in my opinion from last year. Because I'll tell you, you put him out there, like I said, put Hardy, you put Rami and Nick Walker, like, let's see if Hunter belongs with that number, right?
And I say let's weed out the shorter guys. Let's not weed them out, but let's see them compared against each other. Let's see Howdy. Let's see Bonick. Let's see Lungsford. And I had another short guy that I'm forgetting right now. But I'd like to see those guys to see how they come up, and then see them compared, the best two out of those compared against some of the monsters.
And you know what else? There's another one I'd like to see on the stage at the same time. And I know that this is whatever, Cray, but I want to see Andrew Jacked out there. I want to see him next to Blessing. And then I'd like to see guys like some of the new guys also that haven't been out there. I'd like to see like the whole a nice, you know, lineup of all five newer Mr. Olympia competitors. Andrew Jacked, Blessing, Lungsford, Chris. You know what I'm saying? Something along those lines. And then see where these new guys are and where they're exactly going to fall next year. So I don't come on the show and embarrass myself saying that, you know, oh yeah, I don't think this guy belongs here because I've never seen him in the Mr. Olympia lineup before. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Another one to get against Blessing is Akeem Williams. If he's, I don't know if he's going to be in it, but if he's in it, I want to see him up against those guys. And that's where I think he'll end up. It's conditioning seems to be a problem with him.
Yep. Like I said, down the line, Charles Griffin, I don't really think has much of a shot. USA, no. I think I want to see what he looks like out there. Obviously not with the big dogs. Akeem Williams, as stated, and Patrick Johnson. What happened to him, brother? What happened? Patrick Johnson, I had so much promise. I wanted to bring him up before we left. Patrick Johnson was a guy that, you know, worked out with Phil Heath and was, you know, basically he made a huge jump 1 year. And since then, he's had some injury problems. And I just would like to say, I want to see exactly what he's looking like right now and if he's the promising prospect we once thought he was.
Right. Yeah. I don't have much. I don't know much about Patrick Johnson. Like I said, he was a flash in the pan so far. He's been a flash in the pan so far.
That porn mustache for days, though.
Yeah. He's beautiful. I'm not sure. I mean, it'll be interesting to see if he even shows up. You know, they haven't said exactly who's going to be competing yet. So I'm not sure.
Well, guys, this is going to be a lot of fun. It will be available on Olympia TV, guys. All kinds of places you'll be able to find this pay-per-view. There's the whole weekend. They got the 212 going, bikini, fitness, classic physique. I mean, any shock as you see out there? I think Clarita wins 212. Is there any shock as you see coming around the mountain?
I don't. You know what I mean? And I don't know the other classes. I don't follow the other classes closely. Guy, I know this. I gotta tell you, though, over the years, I've become a fan of the classic physique. Yep. Now that I see the classic physique actually look like the physiques of the 70s, and they're about the same weight, and Chris Bumstead is he's unbelievable.
Yes,
I mean, if you look at him, he's like a modern-day Arnold. He's taken Arnold's physique and made it look like what it would look like with today's nutrition, with today's conditioning and everything. And I just think I marvel at that guy.
And Bumstead had a quad injury. You know, messing around or whatever. But now he seems to have worked through it. We'll see exactly how he looks going out there. I think he's going to be the odds-on favorite to take Classic. The other thing I was going to say about that is now he joined forces with Hani Rambod also, right? And he's doing a little bit of work with Hani. And, you know, it's like all the guys working with Hani, I think, are going to be up the top of their class. And it's going to be an exciting weekend. I know that you're going to have a blast. The expo will be out there. You know, definitely get yourself over to Secret Pizza. You know, guys, all my favorite spots. Budweiser Bear Park. Guys, we're coming to do a show live from Budweiser Bear Park. Who knows? Maybe Sug will be a guest on the show next year live from the Strip. That would be fantastic, wouldn't it, Sug?
Oh, I do that. I'm in on that. I'll book that now.
I love it, guys. It's been a great show, and I'm having a fantastic time. But when the music hits, you know what that means, ladies and gents. It's that time of the night. Ladies and gentlemen, with Sug, we got Last Call. Last Call, as always, being brought to you by Clearwater Distillery. Clearwater Distillery is the official top shelf alcohol, the Happy Hour Social Club, and the most delicious small batch alcohol on planet Earth today. Promo code King Hap will save you 10% site-wide, guys. Make sure you get over there. It is the only promo code that'll save you anything over at Clearwater Distillery, guys. Right now, if you guys want to get over there, I know they got discounts on shipping. The November shipping program, over $50. It has ended, but I believe now they're down, they got it at like $75 or something. But get yourself a couple bottles, guys. Have it ready for Christmas, and you can stop pounding after this weekend so you don't get bloated for the Mr. Olympia, right, Sug?
That's right. Don't want to come in holding water.
Yeah, buddy. Sug, quick question for you. Should anybody want to follow you on Instagram, anything like that, where can they find Mr. Sug?
They can only find me on Facebook right now. Instagram to come. I'll come on back onto the Happy Hour. I got a couple projects that I'm working on right now, and I'll let you know.
Boom. I love it. Guys, I'll tell you what. You haven't seen the last of Sug because we are going to have a lot of fun. We'll be getting updates from him. Follow me on Instagram, king.hap. I'll make sure I go ahead and put up pictures and everything from the event as I'll be getting them live to my phone. We appreciate you. Here during Last Call, I want to go ahead and I want to just say, should you guys, anybody in the Happy Hour Social Club, fall on tough times in the holiday season, the Happy Hour Social Club has your back. Feel free, go ahead, reach out to me, whoever in the Happy Hour Social Club you feel comfortable with, Beantown Bad Boy, Ants in the Pants, Taco, anybody. We will send you gifts to put under the tree. Do not let Christmas and financial difficulties in this economy bother you, the Happy Hour Social Club is here for you. HappyHourSocialClub.com, Happy Hour Social Club on Instagram, and your boy, King.Hap on Instagram. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Soog, I want to give a quick shout-out to you, and I want to thank you, brother. Good to see you feeling better and back here in the Happy Hour. We appreciate you, my man.
I love you, buddy. Take care.
All right, guys, what we're going to do, we're going to kick it out of here with the one and only Abyss. It's version 3, ABV3. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see you next week. I love you.
Yeah. Abyss. Happy hour. Hey, how we doing? Doing the podcast better, so fall back, yes, sir. Cause we the ones on top. Sports talk, all you tuned into the King Hap, dude with the big stats and interviews, but they hot. Way he connects with guests on spot, top tier, yeah. But you know what's up? It's the Happy Hour Social Club. Act like a punk. Stand for the friends, so raise that glass to Lorenz. Yo, we're beat out bad boys. Speak facts, not hacks like a tabloid. Strong like an asteroid. Leather paws, they soft like a cat toy. Bring the noise like band camp. Cranking the volume with ant rants to big. Group that listen. It's us, sports talk, the realest. There ain't a podcast better. So fall back, yes, sir. Cause we the ones on top. Sports talk on lock. Come on! Come on.